Good morning, students. How are you all? I am wonderfully well. Thank you. I am going to teach you social studies for the class 3. Let us start. Before going to the topic, I would like to tell you that we are all human beings. We live. What are all the things we want to survive? What are all the things we need to survive? Tell me. Yes, we need food to survive, we need shelter, we need, and more importantly, we need air to breathe. Am I right? We human beings, what we do? We breathe in fresh air, and also water is also very much important to us. Like air, water is also very much important to us. So where do we get this fresh air from? What is fresh air called? Fresh air is nothing but oxygen. So where do we get this oxygen? Oxygen is provided, available only on the planet Earth, on which we live. What is the planet on which we live is called Earth. Am I correct? Don't say it Earth, call it Earth. Okay, so that is the name of our lesson today, is the Earth. The Earth, which is our home. What is it? Which is our home. Why is it our home? Because it gives things what all we need. It fulfills everything what all we need. What the things which are essential to us, like water, air, shelter, and everything, the land is present, everything it gives to us. So that is why the Earth our home. Every morning we see the sun rising in the east. What do you see when you wake up? You see a sun rising in the east. So what does it brings? It brings light. We can able to see, we can see all the things around us. Why? Because it is light. The sun brings us light. So that is called day. It brings the day for us. And as same like that, when the sun sets in the west, in which direction the sun sets? The sun sets in the west. So what it bring? When the sun set, what do we see in the sky? It becomes very dark. When we go out, when we see out of the window or the balcony, what do we see? The climate is very dark. So what do we see in the sky? We see the twinkling stars. The stars are shining brightly, and also the moon. So the when the sun sets in the west, what does it bring? It brings the night to us. Am I right? Yes. So we can see the twinkling stars, the sun, the moon, and the stars. What all we can see in the sky? The sun. When the sun rises, we see the sun. And when the sun sets, we see the moon. And the stars were in the sky. So these are all together called as, what are they called? Heavenly bodies. Heavenly bodies. The sun, moon, and the stars, these are all together called heavenly bodies. Now, do you know that even a sun which rises and which sets, that is also a star. Sun is also a star. And what is the moon? The moon is a satellite. What does a satellite do? A satellite revolves around the sun. Yes, moves in a circle. That is a natural satellite. The moon is a natural satellite. Then going, the sun has a big family. We have a family, am I right? We have big family, we have small family. In the same way, the sun also has a big family. What is that big family? It is a solar system. What does this solar system consist of? Solar system has the 8 planets, the sun, the moon, and the stars, and as well as many other satellites from other planets. Okay, so what is that? The big family of the sun. What is the big family of the sun? Is solar system. What is it? Repeat after me. Solar system. This solar system has all the heavenly bodies, include heavenly bodies. What are the heavenly bodies? The sun, the moon, and the stars. And also has the 8 planets. What is it has? 8 planets. And also these heavenly bodies. Solar system has the heavenly bodies and 8 planets. So the planet on which we live is Earth. It is 3rd planet. Am I right? Yes. So what does this all planets do? All the planets move around the sun. These all 8 planets. How many planets are there? 8 planets. These 8 planets, what all they do? They revolve around the sun, move around the sun. Earlier, the scientists thought that Earth is in the center. But later on, by knowing more, they proved that not the Earth, but the sun is in the middle of our solar system. Okay. And sun is the head of the family, and other things, all the other which are present in the sky, they move around the sun. Our Earth is the 3rd planet in the solar system. The moon also belongs to the solar system. Even the moon which we see at night, that is also belongs to the solar system. So when the sun rises in the east, it gets us day, it gives us day, it brings us day. And at same time, when the sun sets in the west, it brings us night. So can we see the sun at night? No. Why can't we see? Because it is the full of darkness. This moon covers the sun. It revolves around the sun, right? It is a satellite which moves around the sun. So when this moon covers the sun, it becomes dark. So we call it as night. We can't see the moon, which is not visible. It is present there, but it is not visible to our eyes. We cannot see, it is invisible. Okay. Then next, the Earth is the home of all living things. What is the Earth? Earth is the home of all the living things. What are the living things? Which can move, which can do the work, which can breathe in, which can breathe out. Yes, the things which can do the work by their own. These are called living things. What are the living things? Human beings, animals, and plants. These are all the living things present on the Earth. The Earth is suitable for living things. This planet Earth is suitable for living things. So living things need to survive. They need to move around. They work very hard. So we have to survive. We have to live. How can we live? By eating, by having a shelter, by getting some air. What is the main thing which is essential to us to live? The air which we breathe. If there is no oxygen present around, we can't live. Why? The oxygen is the main thing which we want to breathe and which can live life happily. So that is the most essential thing to live on the Earth. So here air is available only on the planet Earth. How is it available? Because it is surrounded by a layer of air. What is Earth surrounded by? We are living on the planet Earth. It is surrounded by a layer of air. Now what is layer? Have you seen an onion? If you take an onion, when we peel it off, when we cut it, what do we see? We see many layers. So many layers form one onion. In the same way, here earth also has a layer of air. What does it has? Layer of air. Layer of air. This layer of air has a name. What is the name of this layer of air called? Atmosphere. What is that? Atmosphere. So because the layer of air is present, so we can breathe in the oxygen. So not only the oxygen, many other gases are also there in this layer. So that is, this layer of air is called atmosphere. That is why human beings can live life happily on the planet Earth. Am I right? Okay. Next, about 3/4 of the earth is covered by water and 1/4 is land. If this is an earth, okay? Now, if we divide this into 4 parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, then these 3 parts are covered with water. And this is air. Land. It has a layer of air and 3 part of the earth is covered with water and 1 part is land. So what do we need? Mostly we need water and air to live. So 3 part with 3/4 part is covered with water. So that is why it is very easy to live, for living things to survive on the earth. Okay, all living things need air and water to live. What all living things need? Air and water to live. Thus life is possible on the earth. That is why life is possible on the earth. We can live life happily without any difficulty. Why? Because the layer of air is present and 3/4 of the earth is covered with water and 1/4 is land. Land where we can construct houses or anything. What do we need? What all people want? They can live life happily only on the planet Earth. Now, you might be thinking, what is the shape of the earth? How does this shape of the earth? Who bought this shape of the earth? Who learnt this? We'll be learning next. Shape of the earth. In ancient time, people thought that the earth was flat. Ancient time, people thought that, the scientists who discover, who go on the trip and search, so who learn many things and tell us what they have learned. So here they thought that earth is flat, which is straight. Then they were scared of traveling too far of places for the fear that might fall off the edges. But there were people like Aristotle and Copernicus who said that earth was not flat. They said that earth is shaped like a ball and has no edges. So here, earlier they thought that the earth was flat, but scientists like Aristotle and Copernicus, who is a Greek scientist, and Copernicus, they proved that, they said that, they went on studying, they said that earth is not flat, but how? It is round, shaped like a ball. Do we play with the ball? How is it? It is round in shape, right? So here they discovered that earth is shaped like a ball. It has no edges, no corners, nothing. It is round in shape. About 500 years ago, in the year 1519, a Portuguese sailor called Ferdinand Magellan started on a long voyage from Spain. So what happened? Not now. 500 years ago, in the year 1519, a Portuguese sailor. Sailor is a man who goes on a voyage, who goes in the search of something by through voyage. Voyage is going on ship or boats like that. Ships they go through the oceans. So who is that scientist? Who is that sailor? Ferdinand Magellan. Ferdinand Magellan, he went on sailing, started on a long voyage from Spain. Where did he start? He started from the Spain. He wanted to prove that no one could fall off the earth. So he wanted to prove that when we even travel more and more, we cannot fall off the earth. He himself could not finish the journey, but his sailors continued to sail in only one direction. To their surprise, after 3 long years of sailing, they reached the place from where they had started the voyage. So they sailed for many years. They went on the journey to prove that we cannot fall from the earth. This man wanted to prove that we cannot fall from this earth. So he went on doing the journey. Then they started the journey from Spain and moved on, going on a journey. Then after many long years, they reached the same place where they have started the journey. So this proved that what it is proved, when you start from a point and go again, come back onto the same point, what it is? It is like a circle. So this man proved that the earth is round in shape. Okay, actually the earth is, it is also proved that earth had no edges. In fact, it was round like a ball. So he proved that earth has no edges, it is round like a ball. Actually the earth is round like an orange. Have you seen the fruit orange? How is it? It is somewhat slightly flat on the top and slightly flat on the bottom. So in the same way, here they prove that earth is not exactly like a ball, but slightly flat from the top and slightly flat from the bottom. If you stand on the roof of a building in your city, when you go up on your terrace and when you see, so what do you see there? You see that the sky and the land is meeting. Am I right? You see that they are meeting in one point. This meeting point is called horizon. Horizon. What it is called? Horizon. Where? What does the meet? Land and sky. Meeting point of land and sky is called horizon. The place where land and sea meet is called coast. So in the same way, where land and sea meets is called a coast. Coastal region, we say. Where when you go to a beach, you see a place where land and water meets. Yes or no? We play there, we see the sand over there. So that point is called a coast. So what is the difference between a horizon and a coast here? Horizon is a place where land and sky meets, and the coast is the place where land and sea meets. Here land means maybe a land or water. Even a land, even a water is also same. Here land or water and sky meets. Here in a horizon we see that a sky meet. That point is called a horizon, and where the land and sea meet is called a coast. Have you all understood? So this is what all we have learned today. So what do you have learned today? What you have learned? I have learned many new things here. I have learned solar system. Solar system. What is the solar system? Solar system are 8 planets and heavenly bodies. What are heavenly bodies? The sun, moon and the stars are called heavenly bodies. So solar system consists of a big family. It is the head of the family. Sun is the head of the family. To it and the other planets and the moon, the sun, the stars and every other heavenly bodies move around it. Okay, here you can see it in the picture from your textbook. So here Earth is the planet where living things can survive their life easily. How can they survive their lives? Because a layer of air is present on the Earth, which is called atmosphere, and as well as 3/4 of the part of the Earth is covered with water and 1/4 is of land. So human beings, all living things need water and air to survive. So that is why it is very easy to live on the Earth. For all the living things, it is very easy to live on the Earth. So who discovered the shape of the Earth first? Who learnt about it? Aristotle and Copernicus. Here in your textbook, two pictures are given of the scientists. Who are they? They are Aristotle and Copernicus. Write their names over there in your textbook. Okay. Then who was the man who studied that, who said that, who proved that Earth is round in shape? Who is that? Ferdinand Magellan. In the year 1519, he went on a voyage from the Spain. He started a journey, then after many long years he reached to the same point. So this proved that Earth is round in shape. It has no edges, it is not flat. And but also later on they also discovered that Earth is slightly flat from the top and slightly flat from the bottom. And when you go on a terrace, you see a point where land or sea or sky meet. Yes, we see they both are meeting together. That point is called horizon, and the land and water meet. That is called a coast. So this is all you have learned today. So I request you all to do the think and answer. You turn to the page number 10. Here you have, you do this, write it down. It is very easy. You have learnt all the lesson what I have taught you today. You can easily answer those questions by listening to me. So do it. Thank you. Love you all.